Well, viewers, welcome back to Shine. Of course, the other half of the program has got much in store for you. And as far as this half is concerned, we are going to talk about Christmas especially. And when it comes to Christmas, the people love to send special presents and personalized presents to their loved ones. But there are certain people who have certain concerns like halal food or other dietary issues. So as far as that segment of society is concerned, we have got a very good news for them. We have got the owner of a halal hampers company with us today, named as Hiba Hampers, and the owner is Nazreen. Hello, Nazreen. How are you?
Hello, Kate. I'm fine, thank you.
Thank you so much for joining us today in Shine. First of all, I would like you to tell us about Hiba Hampers.
Hiba Hampers is a concept I set up around about 3 years ago. We were approaching Eid, and Eid was around about the same time as Christmas 3 years ago. Right. So that would be really nice to have a hamper, but not for Christmas, for Eid instead, which should contain all of the things that we can enjoy. We can't have meat products, there are certain products we can't eat, and it's a shame receiving a beautiful hamper if you have to throw half the contents away. So what I did was I came up with an idea where we can have non-alcoholic drinks, we can have halal chocolate, we can have halal foods in there, halal cake, and traditional things like mitai as well, because people always like to give mitai. So we put together a little concept where we had all these gifts put together, but then the other problem was, us Asians don't like to have anything that's going to look plain. So the package that it had to come in had to look equally amazing. So the concept that I came up with alongside my sister as well was something that's going to be handcrafted and handmade for individuals where they would receive a gift and it was completely bespoke for them.
And we have got a couple of samples with us today as well, and they are lovely. They look really stunning. They're beautiful. And the best part is that they are handmade.
Every single one of them. So all the decorations that you see on the baskets, we get plain baskets and we actually decorate these ourselves. So as you can see, this one, the green and white one, that is specifically for Christmas. Right. So all the decorations on it are festive, the contents are going to be festive. We'll have the Christmas crackers, the Christmas cake, the mince pies, because we don't want to miss out on all those things. So we still put all those things in, but it's got the festive look about it. Whereas some of the Eid hampers would be decorated in a different way. We wouldn't put maybe as much decoration on or the tinsel or the other festive look, but it would have more of an Asian look, more Islamic look, and the colours that we would use would be more Islamic as well. But more importantly, we would emphasise that everything is absolutely halal, including the gift, which is the drink, which is non-alcoholic.
And I believe that you have recently introduced the drink. In fact, through our show, you are introducing this drink.
Very, very lucky, because nobody has seen these yet, but we're launching our own brand of non-alcoholic drinks, which is called Juwani. Well, the drinks are there, and they have an Asian ethnic look about, and they're completely non-alcoholic. It's sparkling grape juice. It's fantastic as a celebration gift. You open it up, you can pop open the cork.
Oh, wow.
And we've given some of these bottles to lots of different people, and they've absolutely loved them. So the enjoyment of opening one of these bottles to the extent where the flavour is absolutely
gorgeous. To mark the opening of the festival or something, anything like that.
For weddings or for Eid, we've supplied lots of charities with drinks for their dinners. And when they start popping open the drink, you know, the atmosphere livens up a little bit. Yes. So just a little bit of fun, a little bit of celebration and for weddings as well, you don't want to go to a place where they have your bottle of Lilt or your Coke, and it's not something that you can give as a gift. So our non-alcoholic wines, like I said, completely halal, non-alcoholic, you give them as gifts as well. So they perfectly complement all the sweet mitai you get in the baskets as well.
Well, it's really nice that you have introduced and you are launching these non-alcoholic drinks through our show.
Yes.
What initiated you, and what was your basic idea behind the launching and behind this thing, non-alcoholic drinks?
It was something that was lacking within the Asian community. Drinks have been around for years. You know, we can go and buy a bottle of Coke or buy something like that, but there's nothing fun or festive or celebration-y about it. And with the hampers as well, it's a case of, well, we like to give each other gifts. If somebody you know has a baby boy or girl, it's tradition to give mitai. Well, why not give mitai in a beautiful package with other non-alcoholic and halal items where the recipient can enjoy every single item in there.
Otherwise, we have to like divide the things and we are always concerned, okay, is it suitable for vegetarians, anything like that. So people are concerned about certain things. But when, as far as your hampers are concerned, it's a 100% guarantee that they are 100% halal.
That's our job. It's our job to go out to there and make sure that every single item that we buy is completely halal, it's non-alcoholic. And then when you receive it, you know, you've got the peace of mind that when you're eating and opening one of these, you can eat everything in there. You're not having to go through the labels and the ingredients and throwing half the contents away and keeping the rest of it. So we take that pressure away from you. We're doing it all. We're going to give you a gift that you can enjoy from the minute you get it.
Apart from the baskets, there are other certain boxes which we can see, the one of them.
Yes.
And it's it seems to be a quite unique idea as well.
The products that we source have to be unique. If somebody else has got it, I don't want it. If you're going to get a hamper from Hibba Hampers, it's got to be exclusive. It's got to be bespoke. It's got to be unique. Otherwise, there's no enjoyment. So all the this style basket is a basket that I created. So we have design patent over the style of the basket itself. And then the other baskets, I see like the square basket down there. That's something that I have made for me. We have different styles of baskets which are coming through in the next few weeks as well, which will be completely unique to the UK. You can't get them anywhere else, just from Hibba Hampers.
Oh, that's really nice. And that's
really
a very
stunning.
Unique idea. In fact, the different forms of hampers are available in one place only.
Yes, we do mehndi hampers, we do wedding hampers, we do Eid hampers, Christmas hampers, Diwali hampers, we do Hanukkah hampers. So we can provide for different sections of the community and different, like it's a different dietary requirements as well.
And when we were discussing before the show, you told me that anyone who wants to personalize the hampers, they can tell you the colors as well, that you want the hamper in blue, the ribbons in blue or pink or whatever the color is.
Yes, so absolutely.
Tell us about that.
Because we make the baskets ourselves, it's the ribbon, the flowers, the silk, all of that is done in-house. So if you have a special requirement, say you want to say thank you to your boss at DM Digital, if your color, your corporate color is a certain color, we can make sure that, for example, if it's blue and white, we can make sure that the flowers and the silk and the ribbons are blue and white as well. So when we take orders, it's not a case of, well, I want a Christmas hamper, please send it in the post. No, it's a case of, well, who is it for? What kind of person are they? What do they like? What age group are they? Are there certain things that they like? Is there something that they really dislike? To make sure we avoid those. And that way we can create a unique gift, especially for that person. When that person receives that gift, they know it's for them, because all the contents will be specifically for them.
So what type of customers do you normally come across? Are they very particular about the things in the hampers, or sometimes they leave it on you as well?
We ask them to leave it to us.
Okay.
We do the research, we get the homework done, we know exactly who we're buying for. Our biggest customers and clients are people, are corporates. Heathrow Airport, for example, buy from us. We have the IT companies, we have solicitors, we have accountants. And then we get the individuals as well. And if they have something specific, oh, well, my sister likes this brand of chocolate, can you please make sure that chocolate's in there? So, well, yes, of course, we'll go out in there and get that. And then we've actually made some Mother's Day hampers for some mums who are in their 70s and 80s and 90s. They had a shock when they saw the bottle, but when we explained to them it's completely non-alcoholic, they calmed down a little bit. But even they loved it. So
did they accept the idea quickly? Or
it was a shock to begin with. It was a shock to begin with, because when you see a bottle like that, you think it's going to be alcoholic. And when they realise it isn't and you can drink it, it's completely non-alcoholic, they're absolutely fine about it, and they ordered again next year as well.
Is it written over there on the label as well? Does it say that it's non-alcoholic?
It says on the label it's non-alcoholic, and when you look at the ingredients, there's nothing alcoholic in it, and it's completely non-alcoholic. It's sparkling grape juice.
And people who have certain other dietary concerns, do you keep those concerns in mind? For example, when it comes to a person who has who's diabetic?
Yep, the most common kind of customer who has any specific issues with some of the contents that we have are going to be the diabetic. So we can source sugar-free products, we can source gluten-free products. If someone has something that's completely vegetarian or vegan, we can source those products. So we will take the time out to actually go and source those products. So if you came to me and said, my father's diabetic but I really want to buy him a hamper, not a problem at all. We will go out there and make sure all the products are sugar-free and he can enjoy it just the same as everyone else.
Okay, so you keep in mind while making a hamper, you keep in mind the certain other requirements of a person's
Absolutely.
Health as well.
Because when we're taking a profile of the person who's going to receive the hamper, so we need to know if they do have any dietary requirements. So it's not just a case of what they like and what they don't like. What are they allowed to eat and what are they not allowed to eat? So say, for example, if it's something that's going to be nut-based, they will tell us, this person doesn't like nuts or it's allergic to nuts, we'll make sure we don't put any nuts in there.
And you told me that the number for your company, it's a free number as well, so anyone can have easy access to that number.
Yes, the free phone number is 0800 949 111. It's on all our literature, it's on the website, but yet you ring us. It's completely free to you. You can spend as much time on the phone. We will try to take as much information from you as possible. And then obviously you can go onto the website, which has been live for 3 years, and you can place an order online as well, pay online as well. So it's quite easy, both methods of trying to place an order.
You can tell the viewers about the website address as well?
The website address is www.hiba, spelled H-I-B-A, hampers.co.uk. And incidentally, the word hiba is the Arabic word for gift as well.
Oh,
so it seemed perfect for...
Symbolic,
it would mean something to us. Mm-hmm. So it's perfect to call them Hiba Hampers because it's the same meaning as...
That's really nice. Thank you very much, Nazreen. I wish you very best of luck in your cause, and especially as far as a Muslim community is concerned.